What is up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, we're bringing you a yoga routine for absolute beginners. So if you're new to yoga, this is the class for you. The pace is going to be very slow. So if you have taken any of our classes, you know that we move pretty fast and the classes may be a little bit too advanced, even the easier one or the beginner ones. This one is going to be really tailored for absolute beginners. We're going to be moving very slow, as I said, and Yasir is going to be demonstrating the easier modification of most of the positions. So make sure to follow him if you're on the beginner side. And if you're in the intermediate to advanced side, simply follow me and maybe do this on a resting day. That being said, we'll see you on your mat. For family, let's begin right away in a seated comfortable position. I'm gonna be in a kneeling position, but this can be very uncomfortable if you're a beginner. So what I recommend is just put a block underneath and maybe just get into a regular seated cross-legged position. That one is called, if you wanna know, it's called Sukhasana Easy Pose. Do whatever you have to do with the legs to find a comfortable position, and elevating the hips just makes it a little bit more comfortable. Find that position, whatever that means for you. Place the hands on your knees or on your laps and allow your eyes to close. Begin to focus your attention into your breath. Do not try to change it just yet. Simply observe the quality of your breath. Without judgment, just pure observation. In our yoga practice, the breath is probably the most important aspect of it. It doesn't really matter what we do with our body. As long as we are conscious of our breath, as long as we're paying attention to our feeling, to our thoughts, basically directing our attention inwards, that's all that truly matters to get the most out of your practice. But as always, if you get distracted, do not judge that. Simply come back to your breath. Begin to relax the bottom of your feet, your ankles, your knees, your hips, abdomen, your shoulders, bring them up slowly and back and allow them to fall, using gravity to your advantage. Release your arms, release the tension of your neck and all the muscles of your face. Now do your best to make each inhalation every time longer and the exhalation even longer than the inhalation. In and out through the nose the entire time. Bring both hands to the heart center in a prayer position, keeping your eyes closed ideally, and set up an intention for today's practice. Whether that is being present, resolving something in our mind or in our body, whatever your soul is calling you to do. Keep that intention present throughout the entirety of the practice as an anchor to the present moment. Slowly blink open your eyes. I'm gonna stay in this kneeling position. You can stay on that seated position. We're gonna be doing some twisting and some bending. So I really want you to be super comfortable in whichever seated position you can be. I'm gonna begin by raising our arms up, super straight. Gaze up, send the energy up, elevate those shoulders, so bring the shoulders to touch your ears. And then on your exhalation, release them down. Bring the left hand to the left side and bring the right arm across towards your body. So don't collapse, simply reach up and high, opening up through the chest, and just breathe there. If you want a deeper range of motion, you can bend the bottom arm. If you want less, you can be on your right or left fingertips. Inhale back to center, right hand comes down, left hand goes across or a side bend towards the right. Inhale back to center, both arms up. Now twist over towards the left. You're gonna grab the right hand, it's gonna go to the outside of the left knee. Left hand is gonna go back, maybe to the fingertips. Just hold there. What I want you to do now is use every inhale to get the chest higher and every exhale to twist a little deeper, only as far as you can go. If you want something more intense, simply walk the back hand a little more and twist a little deeper. Inhale back to center, both arms up. Exhale, left arm to the outside of the right knee, right hand goes behind and twist. Once again, inhale, chest up, exhale, twist deeper. Inhale back to center. Now let's move dynamically between all those positions. So follow me, arms up, one breath, one movement. So exhale, go to the left, inhale to middle, exhale, go to the right, inhale to middle, exhale, twist, inhale to middle, exhale, twist to the other side. Inhale to middle, one more of all that cycle. Inhale, exhale, side bend towards the left. Inhale back to center. You might wanna do the twist after the bend, or you want might to side bend towards your side. Use it as a freedom portion of the class to simply move as you like. So I twisted first before side bending, just use side bending before twisting, whatever feels right in your body today. Inhale up. Now bring the hands forward for child's pose. Open the knees wide. Big toes are touching. Simply walk the hands as far as you can go. And you can relax the forehead. Take this time to remember your intention and to come back to your breath. Slowly come up, place both hands in front of you, bring the knees back. So the knees are right below the hips, shoulders are right over the wrist. I'm gonna be warming up a little bit into the wrist by sending the weight forward without collapsing into the shoulders, but pressing the earth away, forward and then back, forward, every time applying a little bit more pressure into the wrist, back, forward, then back. I begin to add little circles towards the right, go towards the left, and now simply move organically however you wanna move. Maybe move the hips side to side, maybe do full circles and then switch, maybe switch when you're in the top, whatever feels nice in your body. There is no right or wrong here. We wanna keep good alignment in our poses, but at the same time we wanna find self-expression as we move. Now, let's find ourselves in tabletop position. Bring both hands a hand distance forward in front of you, shoulder width, and you're gonna curl the toes behind if they're not curled already. Lift the hips and the knees and send the hips up and back for downward facing dog. You can pedal out 1 foot at a time to open into the hamstrings. Getting the heels to touch is not necessary, it's not required. It's the end goal, yes, but in yoga, it's all about the process, not about the destination. So you might find yourself right here. What's important is that you have a length. Length is your spine and the hips are really driving up and back. Whenever you find some movement, you can find some stillness. Gaze is right in between your knees. If at any point in the class you need to rest, feel free to go to child's pose. Now begin to walk the feet forward towards your hands. Your knees might bend if you need that for your flexibility. Get them so they're hip distance apart. keep them slightly bent, and inhale halfway, so lift your chest, lift your sternum, lift your head, and then exhale forward fold one more time. And if you can extend the knees slowly, feel free to do so. Your hands doesn't have to touch the floor. You can grab opposite elbows and swing side to side. Begin to find some space in the hamstrings, in the spine as well. Do a soft bend in the knee as you begin to curl one vertebra at a time, keeping the shin tucked into your chest. So the last thing that raises is going to be your head. From here, inhale both arms up, sun salutation A, gaze at your thumb, exhale forward fold, one breath, one movement. Inhale halfway lift, lift your chest and your sternum, exhale bring both feet back, do an inhale on plank, shift the weight forward, exhale chaturanga. You can drop into your knees for that portion, and you can always do that whenever you lower down. Then release into your chest. We're gonna do a mini cobra first before going into full cobra. Tuck those elbows in, bring the shoulders down and back. Inhale, press into the arms just a tiny bit and find some extension in your spine. Hold for 3, 2, 1, release down. Now let's go a little bit bigger this time. 3, 2, 1, inhale, use your inhale to extend. Hold for 3, 2, 1, release down. Last one, the biggest cobra you can do that is safe. Those 3, 2, 1, inhale, do not force it, do not force it. Keep the glutes engaged here. Maybe arms are fully straight, maybe close to that. Exhale, release down. One more to transfer into downward facing dog. So inhale, upward facing now, or cobra, and exhale, downward facing dog, send the hips up and back. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Hold for 1 second, engage the right side body. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, twist to the opposite elbow, to the left elbow now. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, to the right elbow. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, twist and place the foot to the outside of your mat, to the outer edges, and inhale the left arm up for fallen triangle. Hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Now place a hand where it was, next to the right hand. Bring the right foot back to three-legged downward facing dog one more time. I'm gonna shift the weight forward, drop into your knees if you need to for this push-up, or you can do a single leg chaturanga, lower down, very slow, whether it's in your knees or in your feet. Hold now for 3, 2, 1, push back up. Now lower down and hold it for 3, 2, 1, push back up. Lower down now all the way down into your belly. Use your inhale for cobra or upward facing, and exhale for downward facing dog, but you can go into child's pose if the shoulders are dying at this moment. Second side, inhale left leg up, exhale to the left elbow, inhale left leg up, exhale twist, single down dog, exhale to the left elbow, inhale left leg up, exhale opposite elbow, fallen triangle, adjust as needed, raise the right arm up, hold it for 3, 2, 1, right hand next to the left hand. One more time, you can go into your knees or you can follow me with single leg chaturanga. Let's do 3 pushes, lower down, hold it for 3, 2, 1, push up, lower down, hold it for 3, 2, 1, push up, last one, lower down, all the way down actually. Inhale, upward facing or cobra, exhale, child's pose. Let's bring the knees together this time. We find more roundness in the upper back, the lower back. Find some length in your spine, or you can simply open the knees, whichever position feels more comfortable. Let's have a moment here to get back into our bodies. Do not judge yourself for how you're performing the practice, if you need to stop, if it's confusing at the beginning. As you repeat this practice and any other practice for that matter, the flows are going to become easier to understand. You're going to be building more endurance, more strength, and more flexibility. Slowly send the weight forward, be on both hands, back to downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg up this time. Bring the knee to touch the nose or as close to the nose as possible. Place the foot in between your hands. Drop the right knee for low lunge. You can be right here as Yasir is going to demonstrate, or you can add a little back bend if you're a little more advanced, so you can get the arms up, or you can even exaggerate and really open through the spine. Whichever position, hold it for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Curl the back toes so you can lift up into high crescent lunge. Arms up this time for everybody. Find some balance, find some stability in the pose. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. Now big transition, shift the weight towards the front foot. For beginners, grab your knee, so find your balance, grab your knee. For advanced practitioners, bring the index and middle finger in the inside of the thumb, the toe, and bring it forward. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. Now open to the outside, whether it's the knee or the entire leg. Hold it for 3. You may release this hand for balance, maybe yes, maybe not. 2, 1, bring it forward one more time. 3, 2, 1. Now bring that leg back to the starting lunge position, arms up. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. Both hands to the floor. Bring the foot back, lower down into chaturanga, in your knees or in your feet. Inhale for upward facing dog. Exhale for downward facing dog. Opposite side now. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, knee to nose. Place the foot, lower the back knee. Inhale for low lunge. Find your modification, find your variation. Come back to your breath. Hold it for 3, 2, 1, curl the back toes, inhale for lunge. Hold it for 3, 2, really bend into that front leg, 2, 1, shift the weight forward, either index and middle finger in the middle of the toe or on your knees. Hold it for 3, 2, 1, open to the outside, find your balance, find your stability, find your center. Hold it for 3, 2, 1, bring it back to center. And bring it back to your starting lunge position. Now, pivot both feet to the side of your mat. Adjust your feet as needed. We're gonna sink down into goddess pose. What I want you to do if you're a beginner is support yourself with the hands. Just go as deep as you can go, maybe go side to side. But the ideal goal is what we're trying to build here is a strength and mobility at the same time. So you wanna be sinking down and holding it. But for beginners, I allow you to rest your hands right here. We're gonna be holding this for 5, 4. If you're feeling optimistic today, tiptoes and arms up. 5, one more time. 4, 3, 2, 1. Release down. Pivot both feet again one more time for lunge. Transfer the back foot to meet the opposite foot. Bend both knees. Inhale up for chair pose. Hold for 5. Really sink down, bend into the knees as much as possible, extend the spine. 3, 2, 1. Now, shift the weight forward and begin to drop down very, very slow. You can support yourself with some blocks next to you. If you wanna do it without hands, you will be coming down into a little, little squat. Then do whatever you have to do to get seated. The heels can be off the mat in this case. Once you're here, both pose, we're gonna be holding it for 10 seconds. He's gonna be demonstrating the easier variation with the knees bent. I'm gonna be demonstrating the harder variation. So 3, 2, 1, bring it up. Hold it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower the legs down. Take a deep inhale for a seated forward fold. If you're too tight in your hamstrings and you cannot sit here, you might place a block underneath your sit bones to elevate the hips and make it easier for you. Anterior pelvic tilt, so scoop the hips to the outside, so backwards, chest is up, lean as far as you can go, and you might just simply stay here. As long as you feel it here, that's all that counts. You don't need to be folding yourself in half. And release the hands, come back to your breath. We're combining a strength endurance move with some relaxing for our hamstrings. So use this time, these flexibility positions to come back to your breath. if you feel that your body begins to open up, you can begin to walk your hands forward. And flexibility is all about, it's not all about, but it's a big part to get relaxed into the positions and allow your body to open by itself. If we contract, if we force the position too much, our body's going to tend to contract, and it's going to tend to close down. And as the saying goes, flexible mind is a flexible body. Round two of boat hold, whichever variation you want to do, legs bent or straight, 3, 2, 1, bring it up. Hands forward is a little bit easier, hands up is a little bit harder. Choose your variation, hold it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release down. Now let's open the legs now, tiny bit, just to the edges of your mat. Inhale, chest up, and exhale, forward fold. Now targeting different areas of our hamstrings. Slowly come up. I'm gonna lay down now into our backs. Let's do some back bending. Now, before we go into a very powerful position, very compressed position into a back bend, let's neutralize the spine by bringing the knees close together, feet to the edges of your mat. Simply relax your head and allow your spine to be straight, to be neutral before we go into extension. Now open the knees, bring both feet to be at least hip distance apart. I'm gonna be going for 2 rounds of wheel or bridge. Let's begin with bridge as a warm up. I'm gonna be demonstrating a little bit intense variation. It's gonna be demonstrating a little bit the easier variation. Posterior pelvic tilt, so tuck your table under and engage the core. And as you keep the core engaged, push the hips up into hip extension, relax the neck back. You can stay here. An easier modification would be also to grab the outside of the mat and pull it so the chest can go through. You might stay right here, or you might clasp the hands behind your back and open more into the chest. So hold it for 5 deep breaths. Slowly come back down. One more time, knees in, feet to the outside to neutralize the spine. I'm gonna be going now for full wheel pose. If it's not in your practice, please avoid it. It's not a beginner position. He's gonna be demonstrating bridge again, which is a preparatory position to eventually get to wheel. So whenever you're ready, feet at hip distance. My hands is gonna go underneath my shoulder. His hands are gonna go below his back. 3, 2, 1, whichever variation and position you want to do, push it up. In whichever position, really send the chest back. Open into the chest and do your best to breathe as naturally as possible. Five more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly come down in the same way that you came up. Let's finish our practice with a twist. Bring both legs in front of you. Bring the right knee towards you. Give it a little hug to your knee. Twist it over towards the left. Right arm goes towards the right. And we're gonna gaze at the right arm. You might place a block just like he's doing to support the knee a little bit more. And just breathe. Inhale back to center, extend the right leg, bring the left knee towards you, give it a little hug, twist it over towards the right, left arm towards the left, gaze at your left arm. Inhale back to center. Grab the outer edges of your feet for happy baby to finish the practice. Bring the knees towards you, down, and maybe rock side to side, massaging the lower back. Opening up into the hips. Once again, finding a moment of freedom in your practice. So maybe you want to extend the legs, maybe you want to close the legs. You want to bend the legs and give yourself a huge hug. It's actually all of us do that. Give yourself a huge hug. And thank yourself for showing up today and for making it this far into the practice. Whether it was too easy or too hard, just accept it as it is. And if you find it way too hard to be a beginner class, see it as a goal, see it as something to strive forward. Or let us know down below if you want an easier practice. Extend both legs to the four corner of your mat, two corners of your mat. Both palms are gonna be facing up. Find a comfortable laying position where you can relax for the next 2 to 3 minutes and allow your eyes to close. Release any control of your breath, of your body. Allow gravity to sink you down into the earth. Allow yourself to feel heavy. Just become an observer of your mind, body, and spirit. Whatever you're feeling right now, allow it to be there. It's there for a reason. Whether we subjectively call it good or bad, it's all there to make us grow, to make us improve, to make us better human beings. Our yoga practice is an opportunity to face that, to be in our mat and observe our mind, observe our stories, our beliefs, what's holding us back. Once again, not to judge it, but just to release it and come back to who we really are, our true essence. One minute of silence for all of us to tune in with ourselves and to let go whatever needs to be released. Begin to wiggle your hands and feet. Find some movements in your wrists and ankles. Extend both arms up overhead for a morning stretch. Stretch tall, tall, tall hands to the back of the room, feet to the front of the room. And then release. Turn your entire body to the right side of your mat for a fetus position, which in yoga represents birth, after Shavasana, which represents death. It is the reborn, it is the change in state, it is the evolution of human consciousness. Push yourself up to a seated position, ideally keeping your eyes closed. Bring both hands to the heart center, in a prayer position. Recall your intention, recall the reason why you show up today, and give thanks for simply being able to move, being able to tune in, with yourself, having the opportunity to observe what otherwise could be hidden. We truly thank you for being here with us. May all living beings be happy and free. Thank you for your practice. Namaste. So there you have it, guys. If this routine was way too hard for being a beginner, please let us know down below. We'll make sure to make an easier one. And if you guys want a more intense routine, we'll surely make one of those routines for you guys as well. I want to make a huge announcement. We are doing a massive sale with 70 plus influencers, many of which are my friend and that I highly respect. We have come together to create something called the Yoga Bundle, where you're going to have access to 3 months for our SM Academy, but you also get access to 60 plus different products, including ebooks, apps, workout programs, recipes, meditations, a bunch of programs, all for all these amazing creators. The total value of this entire bundle is around $3,000, and we're selling it for $50. There is not a catch. It's a huge, huge discount. We just simply gather all of us together, and we wanted to give you all our workout programs in the most accessible way, so you can only not access the SM Academy, but you can access this amazing, huge library for amazing, amazing people. All this information is going to be down in the description. It's a huge, huge saving. It's actually ending tomorrow, because we're posting this on Thursday and it's until Friday. So basically tomorrow, you got 24 hours to sign up and get advantage of this deal. Otherwise, if you want to check the SM Academy, the information is down in the description. We got yoga programs for beginner, intermediate, and advanced. So make sure to check that. And with that being said, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, share, subscribe, comment down below what else we like to see on this channel. And the winners from last video giveaway may have shown right here in the middle. And you guys just won 3 months for free as a premium membership to the SM Academy, full access to the entire library of courses, workout programs, or individual moves so you can create your own workout, or HIIT section, or mindfulness section, or calisthenics skills section, or hybrid home workout experience so you can work out at home, and basically everything that is the universe of the SM Academy. Remember that we post every Thursday at 12 p.m. EST, and if you comment within the first 60 minutes of the video, you get a chance to win the giveaway. That being said, we'll see you all next week. Much love. The winners from last video giveaway are going to be shown right here in the middle. No, ¿verdad? ¿Sí? Oh, okay. Oh, okay, this is a blooper. This, you remember this. Pinga! Pinga! Vamos!